I don't think of myself as a poet. I feel that I'm a poet just after I've finished a poem for about an hour, if it's a successful poem. But most of the time, I don't think I'm a poet at all. I don't think of myself as being anything particularly.
Dannie, what's the use of poetry?
I think people hunger for have spiritual needs, and one of them, I think, is to read poetry. I think for them, poetry can be a great pleasure. I read poetry, other people's poetry, because it gives me a great pleasure, and it also helps me to see the world from a slightly different focus than I would have otherwise seen it, I guess. Golders Green itself is a place that I dislike in some ways. I'm certainly not neutral to Golders Green. I think it's a good thing for a writer to live in a place to which he doesn't feel neutral. I think, for example, that Graham Greene can go off to Mexico and apparently hates Mexico and writes a very good novel with the Mexico as a background. But to live in a place which is completely innocuous and don't have any feeling about it at all, I think is not a useful thing for a writer. So I have an ambivalent feeling, I guess, about Golders Green. It certainly comes into my poems because it represents middle-class commercial life in a way to which one can react against.
Now, as well as being a poet, Dannie, you're also a doctor, of course. Has this been a big influence on your work?
Well, until about 1963 or 64, I didn't manage to use what medical experience I had. I wasn't able to incorporated into my poetry. And I asked myself this question, why is it that I can't use my medical experience to help me make poems? And the very asking of this question was helpful. Louis Pasteur once said about scientific inspiration that chance favors a prepared mind. And it's true about artistic inspiration. Now, I was prepared to write medical poems, and chance favored me to do that, so I wrote about 8 or 9 or 10 poems which have definite, explicit medical experience in them.
How do you write your poetry? I mean, is it a question of waking up in the mornings and writing 10 lines, or what?
No, I write poetry when I have a need to write it, when a poem is insistent enough, when the lines become very insistent. And it may be that a few lines may occur to me as I'm saying just before seeing a patient. These lines I have to put one side because a patient may come to me and needs to pour out his troubles and tell me what's wrong with him. And during that period, let's say for 3/4 of an hour, 1/2 hour, whatever, I can't think of those particular lines. Now, when he goes out and I've written down his notes and I finished with him, maybe before the next patient, those lines present themselves to me again. If they don't, then the poem really wasn't worth pursuing. It's only, as it were, if the poem says, here I am, write me down long enough and loud enough that it'll get written.
Are you influenced by other poets?
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of influences in my work which I've tried to discard because I think, you see, what every poet wants to do is to become himself. Everybody wants to be the first, not the second, say, Dylan Thomas or the second T.S. Eliot. They want to become the first Dannie Abse, if they happen to be Dannie Abse. So it's a question really of discarding influences. So all those people that I've enjoyed and whose accents have perhaps touched mine, I've tried to get rid of over the years. If my occupation wasn't that of being a doctor, the poetry would be slightly different. If I wasn't 5'8½", maybe my poetry would be slightly different. I don't wake up every morning, you know, screaming, I'm a 5'8½" Welsh Jew. I don't think about it.